This is a work of political and social commentary. The content of this video is not meant for children under the age of 13. Parental discretion is advised.
As if the Democratic primary season wasn't convoluted enough, with dozens of candidates jockeying for position on the debate stages during the early debates, we have a new horse entering the race. Mike Bloomberg, the multi-billionaire media mogul and mayor of New York City, is crashing into the race with a strategy that defies convention and demonstrates the worst aspects of a woke elitist. Naturally, I have some roasted opinions about him, because no one should bypass the political vetting process. The Democratic field can be divided into two groups, somewhat moderate old-school Democrats and much more progressive candidates. The old-school Dems are fighting hard to keep the progressives from taking over the party, but the progressives are making a lot of headway against them with their condemnation of anyone who has, in their opinion, too much money. Enter Mike Bloomberg. This guy falls into neither category. He's the 8th richest person on the planet and owns a huge media company named after him. In a lot of ways, he is the Democratic version of Trump, except in his case, instead of making America great again, he wants to tell America what to do. Bloomberg is the guy who banned the sale of oversized portions in New York City. He's also the guy who thinks that America should be a gun-free zone, coast to coast and border to border. He's also a big fan of banning anything and everything which might contribute to climate change. He promises to make sure that everyone has government health insurance, that medical costs are capped, and that drugs are capped at 120% of the costs that other nations pay. He promises to invest billions of dollars into the education system, lowering the costs of a college education, and ensure that everyone has access to a degree. And the list just keeps on going. If he wasn't a billionaire, I'd say that he's trying to out-Bernie Bernie. Bloomberg believes in his plan so much that he has outspent the rest of the Democratic field on ad buys in Super Tuesday states. I live in one of those states, and trust me, all of that advertising is having an effect when the rest of the field is largely uninspiring. But Mike has his issues. The anti-Trump seems to be borrowing a lot of his talking points from Hillary Clinton. That includes insulting farmers and other blue-collar workers, calling them stupid and their work easy to do. Based on the reactions from social media, Mike keeps a shoe store firmly tucked in his mouth, too. All one has to do is go just a little ways into his past, just a few years, really, to find something else that he said that offends a large portion of the electorate. Yeah, that really worked for Hillary, Mike. I've run some numbers using primary delegate simulators. What those numbers suggest is that given the current course of the primary, no one will win sufficient delegates to win on the first ballot. Mike won't come in first. That'll be Bernie Sanders. Mike won't finish second either. That looks to be Joe Biden. But Mike will likely win over 500 delegates and finish third, given the current state of the race. That's enough to force out the rest of the field and trigger a hell of a floor fight in the Democratic convention. It would certainly force a second vote, and that will bring in the dreaded superdelegates. The superdelegates will likely vote for Joe, but not even that will be enough to win the nomination for him. It will really come down to who Mike picks. And that could be the point of all of this, to either win the nomination or control who else does. Mike's about as welcome in this race as Trump was in the 2016 GOP primaries. It's going to be interesting, to say the least.